Hello everyone, this is Bhavya, working as assistant professor in the department of ISA of BMS ITNM. So we'll start with the first program in a web lab. The question says, write a JavaScript to design a simple calculator to perform the following operations. Sum, product and difference and as well as quotient. So the we'll just your first line here, this is a comment, or the comment in an HTML can be included using these symbols, and again close it using two hyphens and angle brackets. So this is the comment, and any HTML document should have this document structure. Say you need to add a doc type for HTML5, and you need to have a root element called HTML and its respective closing tag, and within the HTML you need to have a tag called head section, so close the head section, and within each head you can also have a tag called title, where you can give a title, say first program or simple calculator. Simple calculator, so close the respective title tag. So this is within head section, and you can have a body section within the HTML where actual element sits. So just give a body. So within body, we'll just include all the elements or all the tags which is required to perform the operations. Let us consider I want to lay out something like this to, because our question is to design a simple calculator. I want to output something like this. So I'll just start creating a table and include these many rows. So we'll see how to create a table. Within the body section, we need a table tag, and we need a border, or it should be border, because by default the table border is none. So we require a border or table, and close the respective table tag, and we'll see how many rows we have in each in this table. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 rows in this table, so we require a 6 pair of tr tags. So this is one, the first row, similarly for second, third, fourth, fifth and sixth. So we have done with six rows. Now we'll start with first row. In a first row, if you observe, the maximum columns in this particular table is 4. In a first row, there is only one column. So what we will do, we merge these columns using an attribute called column span. So we need only one column, and that should be span. All the four columns should be span, so column span is equal to 4. Just close this, and what is the value which we need to print here is by default it should be 0. So just give 0 and close td. So here we have done with first row. In a first row, only one column and maximum 4 columns, so that should be span, so column span is equal to 4, and the value which we need to display here is 0. In a similar way, we'll just start with second row. In the second row, we need to have two columns. First one is the merging or the span of 3 columns. So we need to have 2 td here because 2 columns is required. So just close this td, within which column span is equal to 3 because 3 columns is span. And what is displayed in the first column of second row, it is AC. So just keep KC. JS is near is nothing but clear the contents. So again, one more column with the value divide by symbol. So we, again here we have done with second row. In the third row, we have 4 columns. So 4 pair of TD tag is required. So in the first pair, it is 7. So close TD tag. Similar way for the remaining contents, 4 columns in third row, 1 is 7, 8, 9 and star. So 7, 8, 9 and the other one is star. So here we have done with third row with 4 columns. Similar way we will do for the remaining rows. So just copy paste this, within which I'll include what is the value? 4, 5, 6. 4, 5, 6 and minus. 4, 5, 6 and minus. Again in the next row, copy paste this. It should be 1, 2, 3 and plus. So it should be 1, 2, 3 and plus. So we've done with this row. And second last row is first column in the last row is the merge of two columns. So what I'll do is td column span is equal to 2, and what is the value which we need to display there is 0. So 0/td. So we have done with first column in last row, and you need to have two more columns with dot and equal. So dot and next one is equal. So /tds. So we have done with the table creation, but that each and every cell here in this table is just a cell in a particular cell in a table. Now we need to make this as a clickable button because we need to give input by clicking on this particular values. We need to make this as a clickable button. So how will you do that is include a button tag. So in a first row we don't want any buttons. It should be a proper cell in a table itself. So all these remaining cells in the table should be a button format. So what I will do for this, include a button tag and place this ASA within button tag. So now the content of the content of the second row first column is a button now. So if you click on it, it should perform respective action. So what action it should perform is on click call a function. Say I'll write a function called push button or something, push button, and pass a keyword called this. So what is this? This is nothing but this refers to an object which contains a method being invoked, which will tell you which particular method is being invoked when you call this particular function. So here this function is being used upon clicking on this particular button. Similar way we'll do for remaining buttons. So I've just included a button tag for all the other values. So for this second, third row, for this again include a push button, again include a button tag, on click push button this, use a semicolon and close this and perform this. So here we have done with a table tag, we have created a table and made all these except the first row, all the remaining rows should be a clickable buttons. So we have done with this. So now if you click on this particular button, what action it should perform, that you need to write it within a function called push button, and we'll place it within a JavaScript. So I'll just start writing a JavaScript function. JavaScript functions should start with script tag. So on type is also required, type is equal to text plus JavaScript, and then here we are receiving the element what we are clicking on. So this, what is this document dot get element by id is, on this returns an element that has an id attribute with the specified value. This is one of the most common method used in HTML DOM, that is document object model. This is used every time whenever we want to manipulate or get the information from an element on your document. And these ID, whatever we are using, it should be a unique one. So for this, we'll just, if you observe here, we have just created an ID for a first row. So id is, this is the first row, correct? First row, one column. So we have given id input label. So this is input label referring to a first row in a table. So this is referring to that particular element. So next we have a function in JavaScript, say push button, which is called upon clicking on a particular buttons. And this object, this has been passed as an object, so obj. And what is this first variable here is pushed is equal to object dot inner HTML. So what is this inner HTML? Again, it sets or returns HTML content of an element. So in this example, it returns an HTML content. Say for example, if a user press a button, say 3, object is ref. This is nothing but it is reference for this particular element. And inner HTML will returns the content of that element, that is 3. So that is why, and we cannot simply write inner HTML. We need to refer it. So that can be done using this object. So object.innerHTML will return the value of a button, whatever you have passed. So in this example, if you press 7, 7 should be passed and place it in a variable called pushed. And then what we are doing is check each and every variable here. If it is equal to equal, if it is equal, then we need to evaluate the mathematical operations, either addition, subtraction, whatever. So if it is evaluate, input label is the ID which we are referring to the first row, and inner HTML, which means we are writing on to a evaluate whatever we have written in the first year, in the first row. Say for example, 2 plus 3, user has clicked 2 plus 3, that will be displayed here. That value you are evaluating and placing in input label dot inner HTML. So again, input label is first row itself. So I'll just show you the output, 4 plus 3. So now input label dot inner HTML is nothing but 4 plus 3. That will be evaluated using a predefined function called eval, which will evaluate the expression. And once you click on equal, because our symbol is equal, once you click on equal, it will perform the evaluation and place the value again in a first row. First row can be again referred using its ID, that is input label, inner HTML. Now here you are setting the content to a inner HTML element. If it is AC, just make the inner HTML value to 0. Else, if you just check if it is value is 0, just place the value as 0. Say for example, AC will clear. If I just press 0, so the 0 itself will be pushed. That is what this if will do here. And then else, if any other element is pressed other than AC equal and 0, you just keep on appending it. So it is not plus symbol, it is keep on appending. For example, 2, then again plus is appended to the string, again 3 is appended to the input. So this is what your push operation will do. So here we have done with HTML document, the perform operation, everything is performed. Now we need to make the look and feel to be different using CSS. So what did we do is using a style sheet here. So style type is equal to text slash CSS, because it is a CSS. And for the entire body, background color is equal to light green. And here we have used ID attribute called, and here we have done a division for this particular table, which should be class name given for that particular division is container. So dot class is nothing but class selector. So for this particular class, apply this style. Again, for a table, use this properties. And this is nothing but ID attribute. So this is for an ID attribute, and this is for a class, for a particular class. Use the applied styles, whatever which we have given. And there is no restriction upon using the same property value pair. You can use different property well, but the output should be in a proper format. And we'll just try to execute this program and see. So I can perform operations like division, multiplication, all these values, and press equal, it will call a evaluate function and give the result in the first row. Thank you.